suspect this guy doesn't want to be controlled by my hips. Because if he's on top of my hips, right here, where does he move? Where does he move? What did I say there? When his hips are on top of my hips, where does his hips move? Wherever my hips move, right? So we got to understand that. So if he's good on bottom, he's got to understand that his hips being on top of mine isn't a great idea. So he is constantly going to be trying to hop out of my lap. All right, we have to know that. Again, if you want to know how to be good in a position, and you haven't really been in that position before, figure out what the other guy doesn't want in that position. That's usually the constant battle, right? So when we're neutral on our feet, he wants to be in a good stance. So in order to take him down, what is my first order of operation, my business? To get him what? Out of his stance, right? So same thing here. As we're moving around, grab right, and that's how techniques get figured out, right? It's like, okay, when I get to this position, what do you want to do? You're really good on bottom. I want to get my hips separated. All right, so as a top guy, I got to understand the hip separation in this position is something that I need to be aware of. Right? So that's why we kind of trick ourselves with that 8 points of control. So we're double thigh high and jamming. Alright, we're wrapping, we're getting nice and tight with our hips. Whether he wings down or whether I just take him to this normal position, I'm always trying to get back to 8 points of control. Okay? Always, always, always. He's not very high on my hips, but his butt's not on the mat. So anything that I do, trying to turn this guy, right, I'm still controlling his hips. Anybody see how my bottom knee is under his hip? Anybody see that? That's super important to being good on top. Controlling this guy's hips with my knees right here. Anytime I do a wrist tilt, anytime I turn him with a leg ride, my hips are controlling his hips. You want to be good on top? That's step number one. Learn how to control this guy's hips with my hips. Now, I want you to go out and do both sides, but instead of a claw, I want you to use a half. So everything else is the same, but instead of wrapping with my claw to the spine, I'm putting a half in. It should feel like 10,000 times better, almost like a cheat. Okay? So just real quick, I'm going to double thigh fry jam, and instead of claw, I'm going half. Super simple. Double thigh fry jam, claw. Instead of, or half instead of claw. Float, 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 same position. Alright? Same thing when he wings down. He wings down, I'm going to go to the claw, or go to the half side. Alright? Jam, half, start driving, he wings down, right back to my position. Notice every time I have 8 points of control. Okay? Every single rep. Go!